Matt, we're going to take a look at your five preseason picks. Try not to be all quarterbacks.
Is this not your favorite segment of the
this
year?
This is.
This is how we kick off the season,
is it.
Coach.
Come on.
All right, number five. We're going Trace McSorley from Penn State. The ultra competitor at this position. He can beat you with his legs. He can beat you throwing the football downfield. He takes chances. He's a much better thrower than I think people give him credit for. The challenge is, coach, for Trace this year. He loses a lot around him. All his playmakers on the outside, Saquon Barkley, and then his offensive coordinator, Joe Moorhead. But like Baker Mayfield last year, sort of taking the team on his back, that's what he has to do this year to win the Big Ten.
And I'll tell you what, the offensive line will be much improved, which will help him. Who you got number four?
Number four, we're going Khalil Tate from Arizona. Lamar Jackson 2.0. He is a dynamic player at the quarterback position. Every time he touches the football, he has a chance to score. Now, he needs to work on his throwing, obviously, and progress as a quarterback from the pocket. But I think with Kevin Sumlin, a new coaching staff, kind of a new culture there at Arizona, he's going to thrive. I'm excited to see him. Plus, Arizona is a sleeper team in the Pac-12 this
year,
coach.
Yeah, you know, to me, he's a great athlete, obviously. I want to see how Kevin Sumlin uses him in game time. Number three,
Will Greer from West Virginia. Arguably the best quarterback back in college football. Tremendous season last year. Big time numbers, 34 touchdowns. Guess who's gone in the Big 12, coach? Baker Mayfield and Mason Rudolph. He is the face of the Big 12 conference this year. Has great receivers back, a good offense, a good schedule too. Good, tough non-conference schedule. Keep an eye on him. We know he's going to put up big numbers this year.
Yeah, and we know Dana Holgorsen, the head coach at West Virginia, with this kind of talent, hey, he's willing to throw the ball 60 times a game to win.
Now,
number two.
We're going to get into your boys now.
Oh, okay.
Love this kid, Jonathan Taylor. I mean, this is your prototypical Wisconsin running back, 5'11", about 220 pounds. Good speed. The things he has going for him, he can do everything, but the things he has going for him, he's running behind the best offensive line in America this year. He has a quarterback in Alex Hornibrook that I believe is going to take chances down the field and really open up those defenses to open up the run game. And Wisconsin is a national title team contender. Keep an eye on this kid. 1,800 yards last year as a freshman. He's tremendous.
Hey, and he's got a head coach that enjoys running the ball, not throwing it every time.
Yeah,
I love that.
We got to throw the ball every once.
Number one.
And then we just heard Rob talk about it, but Bryce Love at Stanford. I mean, he's electrifying. Over 2,000 yards last year. He can do everything. I'd love to see him get more involved in the pass game. They don't use him like they used Christian McCaffrey a couple years ago. But he's electrifying, 4.3, 4.4 speed. He's a lot bigger. He's put on about 10 or 15 pounds this offseason. He's such an exceptional player. And also, like Jonathan Taylor, Wisconsin, his quarterback, KJ Costello, is going to be a breakout player. It's going to open up more of the run game for Stanford. Bryce Love, preseason number one.
Yeah, I love him. I want to see him finish strong. Three of his last four games are on the road.
Yep.
You know, big challenge for him there. I like the list. One guy that I would take out, Khalil Tate. I love the guy, but I'm not sure exactly how it's going to develop this season. And I would replace him with, Matt, all we've been talking about in the show is defensive linemen. And you don't have anybody up there. This is a year between Farrell at Clemson, Bose at Ohio State, Oliver at Houston. I believe that there's going to be a defensive lineman in New York at your banquet.
You're going to take out a quarterback for a defensive lineman to win the Heisman?
Absolutely.
All right.